Hey friends, brothers and sisters in the Lord. This is Elder Bo King, and I'm closing out the Book of Psalms. So it's been a long journey. It's been a long time, but we're finally on Psalm 150. And this psalm is a closing hymn of praise. It is God's creation, praises him everywhere in every way. We should join this rejoicing song of praise. And this is the words that it says, reading from the New Living Translation. Psalm 150, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heaven. Praise him for his mighty works. Praise his unequaled greatness. Praise him with the blast of the ram's horn. Praise him with the lyre and the harp. Praise him with the tambourine and dancing. Praise him with strings and flutes. Praise him with a clash of cymbals. Praise him with loud clanging cymbals. Let everything that breathes sing praises to the Lord. You know, there's a song that we sing, and it's called Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. And you know, this is what we do as believers. And I believe that as we praise the Lord, that he breathes into our lives by his Holy Spirit, the joy and the wonder and the love that we all are going to experience one of these days, as the scripture says, in his mighty heaven. Can you imagine what it's going to be like when we stand before the throne of God and the seraphim and cherubim are circling around him, and the praise, the adulation from billions of people are lifting up to the God of the universe? It just fills you with wonder and excitement. Music and song were an integral part of the Old Testament worship. David introduced music into the tabernacle and temple services. We know that from 1 Chronicles 16, 4 through 7. The music must have been loud and joyous, as evidenced by the list of instruments and the presence of choirs and song leaders. Music was also important in New Testament worship. We know that from Ephesians 5, 19, Colossians 3, 16. How could this message be more clear? The writer was telling the individual listeners to praise God. What a fitting way to end this book of praise, with direct encouragement for you to praise God. Remember to praise him every day. In a way, the book of Psalms parallels our spiritual journey through life. It begins by presenting us with two roads, the way to life and the way to death. If we choose God's way of life, we still face both blessings and troubles, joy and grief, successes and obstacle. But through it all, God is at our side, guiding, encouraging, comforting, and caring. As the wise and faithful person life draws to an end, it becomes clear that God's road is the right road. Knowing this will cause us to praise God for leading us in the right direction and assuring us of a place in the perfect world that is to come, and that he has in stores for those who faithfully follow him. Brothers and sisters, let us praise the Lord in all that we do and say. God bless you today.